covering the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. This is WPBF 25 News at 5.
The jury has been chosen, and the DUI manslaughter trial of a local millionaire is scheduled to start tomorrow morning. Thanks for staying with us. I'm Victor Blackwell.
And I'm Tiffany Kenny. As Cathleen O'Toole reports, there are several lines of defense already starting to take shape.
John Goodman was driving a $200,000 Bentley convertible when investigators say he blew a stop sign in Wellington and plowed into Scott Wilson's car. Prosecutors will argue that Goodman was drunk and on a prescription painkiller. The defense team seems poised to point the finger at the Bentley.
In the third row, is anybody familiar with the concept of sudden acceleration?
Renowned attorney Roy Black gave pretty good clues of where this defense will go, asking prospective jurors if they believe this.
The more expensive a car is, the less chance there could be an electronic or...
A prosecution objection meant Black never got to finish that question. As for the Polo mogul's 0.177 blood alcohol level, more than twice the legal limit, the prosecution's investigation turned up a Polo player who has a barn down the road from the crash. A barn with a bar stocked with tequila, vodka, and bourbon. That player says Goodman told him, "I went to your barn that night." Another possible defense strategy arguing the 48-year-old had access to alcohol after the crash.
Do you think it's ridiculous that somebody would drink alcohol to relieve physical pain?
Now, that Polo player with the bar in his barn, he gave some sworn testimony. He says he got invited to a Laker Heat game with Goodman after the crash. He did this in a deposition. The trial obviously hasn't started yet. In that sworn testimony after the crash, he said Goodman asked him if he still had that alcohol in his barn. Live in the newsroom, Kathleen O'Toole, WPBF 25 News.